ordinance number 2012-224, to authorize the CAO to accept funds in the amount of $3,600 from the Federal Emergency Management Agency to transfer $8,400 of matching funds from fiscal year 2012-13 from the general fund, Fire and Emergency Services, and to appropriate a total amount of $42,000 to the Department of Fire and Emergency Services for the purpose of procuring dual sensor smoke detectors for installation in homes in Richmond.
So this bill will be free.
Any other questions? All right, next page, Mr. Clark.
Item number nine, ordinance number 2012-225, to authorize the CAO to accept $176,765 from the National Fish and Wildlife Foundation and to appropriate the increase of fiscal year 2012-13's homeowner utility budget for the purpose of demonstrating how the city and community partners can implement new approaches to restoring urban habitat that benefit water quality, fish and wildlife, and the community health and well-being.
Questions? Chairman.
Members, I have a problem with this. I mean, I think I spoke to the city attorney about this. It looks like the city of Richmond is the only locality that's paying this to one of the, where we were told that others would be paying, and they're not paying. And also now, people are calling me because they're upset that if they don't pay it, they're gonna be fined or blamed for the properties. I don't ever remember talking about that. I think we had discussed that you cannot be penalized if you don't pay the stormwater fee. Now it's being said you are being penalized. One minute you get a letter that says this is not a deal, and then next week you get a letter that says this is a deal, and you must pay by, so basically, what a nice Christmas present from the city of Richmond. The taxes, all these taxes at one time. So, I mean, Alan, did you ever look into that, city?
I believe that the basic issue that the council faces, and the city faces, is that the charter contains a provision that makes imposition of a lien for unpaid stormwater charges mandatory. So, there, in order to avoid having that, you need to have some kind of legislation enacted by the General Assembly to deal with the issue.
Ms. Brown, I think the question you raised is a very valid question. I think this council needs to have another briefing on where we go with stormwater. There's certainly a significant volume of rearage that have not been collected that we've fed more to our attention. And there has been a recent presentation on how they're going to correct that. So I would like to ask that maybe we ask the clerk to coordinate with the Department of Utilities to employ a full presentation to council on stormwater. This paper is in reference to a grant that would be received that would be appropriated to the stormwater utility budget. So it actually adds some money within that budget. And hopefully that, you know, we can deal with, maybe we can discuss whether or not we want to move this paper forward to accept this grant and also ask for a more in-depth presentation on stormwater.
I think we have two issues here. One is, why are we paying the stormwater fee when others are not paying it? And two, how can we put a lien on somebody's property if they have not paid it, when I do not remember us ever discussing that we would put liens on somebody's property or make it a payment, when people are struggling right now with real estate taxes, this coming out, the stormwater, and everything else. I mean, to me, if other localities are not going to be paying it, I think we need to revisit it, and get do away with it. Because it's not fair when we were told, and to me, I think we basically wasn't told the truth. When we were told that the surrounding counties would be paying it, and to this day, they're not paying it.
And what I'm suggesting, Ms. Trammell, is that we set aside time to ask all of those questions and have them to come down and address all of those questions as relates to stormwater. But this thing
Vice President, what I'm trying to say, if we're going to get a grant money, people in the city are going to say, if you want to get grant money, pay our utility, pay our stormwater, because we can't pay it.
I appreciate that.
Especially we just raised, well, I voted against it, but utilities were raised. I mean, people are upset because, as I've said a thousand times, in Chesterfield County, surrounding counties, their utility bills are cheaper every 2 months than what ours is for 1 month.
And I agree, Ms. Trammell, that the paper that is before us is specifically just to receive this grant that would add more money there into that budget for as relates to stormwater. I do agree that we should have a special session to answer those questions.
And we're not putting money in it. We're just taking this grant money. We're not putting any in it.
This is all this is. Thank you. Mr. Drew, thank you.
Madam President, I support the paper. And right, that's what this paper is about, but a couple of at least one of the issues was raised, and that is that we would get a briefing on the stormwater bills. Well, I don't know if we need a briefing when it was clear the mayor said we're not going to collect money. Now, what we need is to get that corrected and see if we're going to comply with the ordinance, which says that you shall collect the money or there will be a lien placed on properties of those who don't pay. So I just think we need to get straight with the law. We need to get briefed.
Well, the purpose of the briefing will be for the questions that needs to be answered, including that question, to be addressed. I'm not, when I said briefing, I don't mean that we just be briefed. There are questions that have been raised, and I think that we should need to have a special session to address it. I don't think that the staff is prepared to address this as it relates to this paper.
And you would assume that by what means Mr. Vespers here, somebody here from the administration, I'm just curious to know why would the mayor publicly state that I can collect the money?
What I was going to ask Mr. Jones and Ms. Trample, if you want answers to your stormwater questions, let's make a decision on whether or not we want to move this paper forward and finish the docket, and then we'll come back to it. Questions and Mr. Jones. That the staff can answer if they can't answer them now. Mr. Samuels.
As I see this paper, this gives the city money to implement new options or opportunities for how to reduce the stormwater, which could very well reduce each person's stormwater fee. This paper is, I believe, a national foundation offering the city money to reduce, to try new things, so that we can try to reduce our constituents' stormwater bill. This is a novel paper. I don't want to say it's the panpipe for Panacea, but this is a wonderful paper that would actually move us in the right direction. I think we ought to move forward.
All right. I just want to make sure that Ms. Scramble and Mr. Jewell understand that this is a different paper. This is a grant. And the questions that you may have as it relates to stormwater deserve to be answered, but it's not written into this paper.
Absolutely.
Keep that separate. So if there are no other questions about this paper, we'll move to the next item on the docket. Mr. Clark.
Item number 10, ordinance number 2012-227, to authorize the CNO.